This screencast demonstrates how to use Excel for multiple regression. Here we have initial reaction rate data, and what we need to do is fit that data to this equation, and by doing that, find our parameters K, A, and B. So in order to do this in Excel, the first thing we have to do is linearize the equation. And the way to do that is by taking the natural log of both sides. So this is going to equal the natural log of R equals the natural log of K plus A times the natural log of the concentration of O3 plus B times the natural log of the concentration of B. So one thing to be careful of is our reaction rate data. And if you notice, what it says here is R times 10 to the 7th. What that really means is that the first piece of data is not 1.5, it's 1.5 times 10 to the minus 7th. And the meaning of that is if you take this 1.5 times 10 to the minus 7th and you multiply it by 10 to the 7th, you'll get 1.5. Now we have to set up our spreadsheet so that we can use this equation to find our K, our A, and our B. So the first thing is not to forget to put the reaction rate as it actually is. So that equals this 1.5 times 10 to the minus 7th. The next thing that we have to do, if you notice, this is the natural log of O3, and this is the natural log of B. We have to put columns for that. In addition, our dependent variable is the ln of R, so we have to find the natural log of R as well. So this first column is going to be the natural log of R. This second column is going to be the natural log of O3. And this third column is going to be the natural log of butane. Now let's go to data regression. On our toolbar, we click data, and over here we have data analysis. If you look at all the choices for data analysis, you see this regression, and you hit OK. In this particular input box, the first thing we need to do is input the Y range, which is our natural log of R. However, what's different in multiple regression is that you can have more than one X variable. So here we have both of these columns as our X range. We click OK. The first thing that we notice that our R squared is about 0.93, which is okay. Our adjusted R square is 0.89, which is a little lower than we would have wanted. But part of it comes from that we only have 6 data points. But the important information is here. That intercept is the ln of K. So the natural log of K is minus 11.2622. This X variable 1 is our A. And finally, this X variable 2 is our B. So let's go back to our problem and put those in. Remember, again, we're trying to find our K, our A, and our B so we can fit this model. Let's write down what we found from our regression. This is the natural log of K. We need K, so in order to find that, K is going to equal E to the ln of K. And when we calculate that out, we find that our K is 1.3 times 10 to the minus 5. And so finally, we can write our reaction rate such that R equals 1.3 times 10 to the minus fifth, the concentration of O3 raised to the negative 0.031 times the concentration of B raised to the 0.161.